permit me, Betsy Soap, to give recognition to our Honorable Chief Secretary and Deputy Political Leader, the Honorable Orville London, Deputy Chief Secretary Tracy Davidson Celestine, a daughter of this village, Councillor Gary Melville, hard-working Secretary for Infrastructure and Public Utilities, and our caretaker area representative, all of the secretaries and assistant secretaries in our midst, and Betsy's Hope, I want to recognize my friend, my colleague, a powerful youth speaker, Ms. Nadine Stewart. Good evening. Betsy's Hope, I am home. My mother was born right down there. I came back here and married the love of my life. And this is where I lived, Betsy's Hope. So I am home. And I'm proud to be addressing you at home. A friend of mine told me a few nights ago that there was a political meeting right here. And she noted the following. She said, one, it had more person at the head table than supporters. Two, she noted that the candidates spent more time discussing Ayanna Webster-Roy. Brothers and sisters, when I heard that, I got real vexed. Because I spend my time on the platform educating Tobagonians on the reasons why they should vote. I spend my time on the platform highlighting my vision for Tobago East. That big man who already had a chance to represent and who failed miserably, he should have known better, ladies and gentlemen. But I will deal with him. Betsy Soap, I will deal with him, but not tonight. Not tonight, Betsy Soap. Come down Thursday night in Roxburgh at 6 o'clock and I will deal with him. Brothers and sisters, enough of the jokers and the dreamers. I want to get down to serious business. I want you to understand why the People's National Movement is the best and only choice come September 7th, 2015. 5 years ago, we entrusted our nation to the People's Partnership Government. And we, like the master in the parable of the five talents, have come to recognize that the outcome of everything depends on whose hands it's placed for nurturing. Our nation, in the hands of Kamala-led government, has entered into a state of decadence. Corruption is the order of the day. Crime is at an all-time high. Our nation's youth are disillusioned. Nepotism reigns, and we are on the brink of social unrest. Brothers and sisters, unlike the servant in the parable who took the talents the master entrusted him and doubled it, our government, like the foolish servant who received one talent, took all that was good, wholesome, and beneficial to the people of this nation and hid it away. Instead of nurturing the blossoming unity that existed amongst our people pre-May 2010, this government, this Kamala Prasad Bisesa-led government, fostered discord, distrust, divisiveness amongst the people. But you know, we have a saying in Trinidad and Tobago. We have a saying that if a fish rotten, it is rotten from the head. So how they could come and tell us that the leader good, but the party bad? If the party bad, the leader bad. No fish will rotten from the tail come up. It is time, Betsy Soap, it is time for us to stand against poor management of our treasury. It is time for us to stand against broken promises. It is time for us to stand against Tobagonians' right to self-determination being used as an election ploy. It is time for us to stand against corruption and wickedness in high places. Although we know they have failed, they failed us, they want us to question the track record of our PNM House of Assembly. They want us to focus on the real purpose of this election. They want us to be ungrateful. Brothers and sisters of Betsy's Hope, ungratefulness worse than Obia. I grew up right here hearing people tell me that. Ladies and gentlemen, we know our PNM Assembly has worked for us. And because we know our PNM Assembly has worked with us, we can be confident a PNM central government will work for us and work for us PNM style, brothers and sisters. I want you all to just imagine how much more we will be able to achieve if we have a PNM central government with a Tobago born and bred PNM prime minister and a PNM Tobago House of Assembly. Brothers and sisters of Betsy's Hope, just close your eyes for a few minutes and just imagine how great it would be. I want to highlight some of the achievements of our PNM Tobago House of Assembly because it will give you a clear indication of what you can expect from a PNM central government and a PNM member of parliament in Ayanna Webster-Roy. I want to highlight improvements in primary health care and more importantly, the introduction of walk-in centers which operate on an extended basis. I, like many Tobagonians, have personally benefited from the services of the walk-in centers. Last year, I had the unfortunate experience of getting the chick V. I was in pain, and I had to leave work and go down to Canaan Health Center. Brothers and sisters, in 15 minutes, I was in and out with my medication in my hand. That is the PNM Assembly working for you. The PNM Assembly cares about our health and well-being. Yes, we cannot be ungrateful. I told you before, ungratefulness worse than Obia. Brothers and sisters, in terms of education, we have more spaces post-primary than we have children to fill the schools. This is performance and delivery, PNM style, brothers and sisters. I had the honor and the privilege to witness a graduation ceremony at Mason Hall High School, and I was truly impressed by the work done, especially with young men. And when I went to the Roxborough Anglican School graduation, it dawned on me, our education system in Tobago is improving. Just like Mason Hall, the boys were the ones cupping the prizes in Roxborough. Our education system under this PNM administration is working for our boys. People, I tell you, ungratefulness worse than Obia. We must remember. So when we go to vote, remember the work being done. In terms of infrastructure development, I can honestly say that this PNM Assembly has delivered. Every time one of my cousins come from overseas, they point out changes to me that I did not even realize. You know we have a saying in Tobago, when things staring you straight in your face is no you don't see it. We have had major road works done over the last 15 years. When I walked Pembroke, I felt the joy and gratitude of residents of Murray Hall who would have benefited from development of their road and drainage system. And Murray Hall is just one community. The residents of John Dial will feel more comfortable to walk along the main road. The infrastructure upgrading the community will see residents benefiting from sidewalks and improved drainage. Brothers and sisters, that is delivery and performance, PNM style. Brothers and sisters, when compared to other Caribbean islands, we have more access to community facilities and recreational spaces available to residents. Almost every community has ready access to a community center, ICT walking center, recreational ground with lighted playing field, playing park, or youth center. Betsy's Hope, right here in Betsy's Hope, we have a modern community center that is being used to facilitate training and development. Brothers and sisters, performance and delivery PNM style. And I must mention, ladies and gentlemen, that we have a library facility that is the envy of the Caribbean, if I dare say so. Every user was taken into consideration. The child, the adult, the elderly, and the differently able was not left out. I have to be honest, it took a while, but when it was delivered in PNM style, brothers and sisters. While the assembly has been able to deliver to the people of Tobago, more could and should be done for Tobago on matters of national concern. This is where we need good representation in the parliament to move our development agenda forward. Because of the lack of representation, the matter of constitutional reform was not addressed. Because of the lack of representation, there has been no improvement in the air and sea bridge. As a matter of fact, the situation has worsened. And I could say that I suffered on the airport last week trying to come up from Trinidad. Because of the lack of representation, the issue of land regularization remains on the back burner, while countless Tobagonians become more and more frustrated. Because of the lack of representation, the Roxborough and Old Grange police stations were not built. Because of the lack of representation, internal self-government was not attained. Brothers and sisters, under my watch, under the watch of the girl you helped to raise as your next member of parliament, I want to give you my guarantee, my promise of excellent representation and representation, PNM style, the same way your own Tracy Davis Celestine has been doing it with fine style and quality, brothers and sisters. Betsy Soap, I want to give you my commitment. I will continue to walk with you. I will continue to listen to you. And more importantly, I will continue to work for you and with you. And unlike the others who will come seeking your support, I will have the honor and privilege of being a part of a wider team, a creditable institution that truly cares about the development of people. Our name says it all, the People's National Movement. We put people first. And unlike the others, with a track record of broken promises and disregard for Tobagonians, the PNM will work for you in the parliament the same way the PNM Assembly has worked for you. While they teased us with promises of internal self-government, you can rest assured that a PNM government will deliver. Mrs. Celeste mentioned that every level of the party, internal self-government has been agreed and approved, so you can expect it under my watch. As a matter of fact, the Honorable Orville London gave me a mandate, the same mandate he gave Champa Kodjo. Within 1 year of our being in office, we have to deliver internal self-government. Brothers and sisters, I am a woman. I love a challenge. So you give me a challenge and I'm going to deliver. And Mr. London, I'm going to deliver PNM style. Brothers and sisters of Betsy Soap, the PNM's policy places heavy emphasis on improving the quality of life of all citizens. Our political leader has stressed the importance of revitalizing the agricultural sector and creating an environment that encourages investment. Our political leader, during his presentation in Market Square 2 Sundays ago, made a commitment to the development of sport and sportsmen and women. Brothers and sisters, when I heard that, I smiled. I know the residents of Betsy Soap have been clamoring for upgrades on the grounds done by Prems. And I know with the necessary upgrades, Betsy Soap will be able to produce more world-class players like Prems Sunwayer. I know that. I will advocate for the THA to get the required funding to facilitate sports development on the island. so that we could continue to produce world-class sportsmen and women. Our PNM government will promote food security by encouraging our farmers to grow what we eat and encouraging our citizens to eat what we grow. The next PNM central government is committed to economic diversification through the creative industries. We know how beneficial this can be to Tobagonians, as the Tobago House of Assembly has invested heavily in training and development to position Tobagonians to capitalize on emerging opportunities within the creative industries. Ladies and gentlemen, we are very fortunate to have one of us, a fellow Tobagonian, at the helm of this great party called the People's National Movement. Dr. Keith Christopher Rowley has the ability to lead his team to victory and to restore good governance to Trinidad and Tobago. With God's help, Dr. Rowley and the PNM government will help to heal our nation. He shares our ideals. Dr. Rowley shares our values and our beliefs, and he's passionate about safeguarding our heritage. Ladies and gentlemen of Betsy's Hope, my family, my friends, I want you to know that Dr. Rowley is the right man at the right time to save this nation. Brothers and sisters, family and friends of Betsy's Hope, I want you to understand that the PNM is the right party at the right time to heal our land. Brothers and sisters, I want you to understand that the People's National Movement, Dr. Keith Christopher Rowley, Ayanna Webster-Roy in the East, Champoko Joy in the West, we are the right time, the right place to build Trinidad and Tobago. God has been good to us, and he has been good to the People's National Movement. I believe his goodness will prevail. Do you believe, brothers and sisters of Betsy's Hope? I believe that his goodness will prevail to victory. Do you believe, Betsy's Hope? Brothers and sisters of Betsy's Hope, friends and family, God has a plan and a purpose for each and every one of us. I believe he has called me into a season of service to the people of my country. So you'd have seen your little girl grow. You have seen your reserve young woman blossom into a powerful, articulate powerhouse, Betsy's Hope.